And to discuss the protests in Thailand, I'm joined by human rights lawyer Emilie Pradichit. Emilie, thank you very much for joining us today on A-News.
Thank you for having me.
6 days of protests. So what are they all about?
So it's been the 6 days today that the youth in Thailand are protesting because they have three key demands, and we call them the three R's. The first one is that they want the resignation of the current prime minister, Prayut Chan-o-cha, and his government. The second demand that they have, they want a revision of the constitution. They want a constitution that is written by the people and for the people, that would bring real democracy. And the third R that they want a reform to the monarchy. They don't want absolute power provided to the monarch. They don't want absolute power provided to the king. They want a real reform to the monarchy with a king that would be below a royal family that would be under the constitution. So this is why youth are in the street right now.
This might sound like a strange question, but what is the people's problem with the monarchy?
The people's problem with the monarchy is that Thailand is still living back in the 19th century or the 20th century. You see, young people have grown up with social media. Young people have grown up seeing what is happening in the country. They are seeing the inequality, the injustice that is happening in the country, and they don't want that anymore. And inequalities and social injustice have been put in place by the monarchy and by the establishment. So they want an end to that. They want to live under real democracy. They don't want full power provided to the prime minister. They don't want full power provided to a minority in the country, to the establishment. They want power that is being shared among the Thai society. They want equality, justice, and respect for human rights for all. This is what young people want.
And from what I understood, the protests have come up from the students initially. Is there any organization behind it?
No, so this is what, you know, the government is trying to say, because the government like to pretend that young people are stupid, that young people are not smart, and obviously there is a third party behind them, might be coming from the US or from wherever, because this is always the argument that the government has been using in the past every time that there was a change, or different every time there were demands for real democracy. So no, young people are very smart, they are fearless, they are smart, they are courageous, and they know exactly what they want. They studied, they have access to knowledge. You know, social media has provided them with knowledge. So no, they are not stupid, they know exactly what they want, and there's nobody behind them. They just have their brand, and they just want equality, and nobody is behind them.
So in reality, let's say that the demands are met and the Prime Minister steps down and there's an agreement to write a new constitution. If there's no organisation, then how would that be written?
There are organisations. Like, you know, before the general election, there was the Future Forward Party, which is a party that everybody, all young people, has huge hope in that party, because it's a very mix of young people, of people coming from the private sector, but also people coming from civil society, people who want to bring equality and justice to the country. That party was dissolved under the current prime minister. Because that party represents fear and represents danger that Thailand will become a democracy, it brings hope to young people. So there are political parties in place. There are parliamentarians that are here to bring democracy, that are here to bring equality and justice. Like, if the prime minister resigns, we hope that there will be free and fair elections where people will be able to elect their own people to write a free and fair constitution.
So it sounds like there's quite a huge job to be done between the hoped for resignation of the prime minister and the holding of elections. If one party has already been banned, and that's the party that the students would support, then obviously there needs to be a total turnaround of the books. Do you think that these protests can achieve that?
You know, the protests have been ongoing for the past 6 days, and young people are not going to step down. Every day they find new tactics, they are very smart, they are very strategic, and they are not going to step down. Although the Future Forward Party was dissolved, there is a new political party called the Moving Forward Party. So if there are free and fair elections, you will see that there will be a lot of parliamentarians elected under that political party, because the past general election in October 2019 were not free and fair. Mm-hmm. And that new party came number four in the country, which was huge, you know, for the Thai history. So right now, young people are making history, and we hope that they're going to keep making history. And we have hopes that they're going to succeed and they are not going to give up. They are every day in the streets, they are nonviolent and peaceful. This is really important to remind that young people in Thailand that are protesting are nonviolent and peaceful, unlike the military-backed government and police officials that have shown violence against them.
Of course, one of the big issues is that many of the protesters have been arrested, and there are issues surrounding freedom of speech. Are there organs that are able to communicate what is actually happening in Thailand in the way which you think is realistic? Are we learning the truth?
To be honest with you, we are trying our best on social media. Young people, many organizations like Manushya and others are trying our best to share information. The government has, like the Prime Minister, has issued emergency decree. Since 15 October, every day they are issuing new decrees, new orders to restrict our online freedom. Today, they restrict a new order to restrict independent, four independent media, but also the three youth social media webpage. They are also, you know, asking internet service provider to block information that are going on through the Telegram online messaging application. The government's trying to control our online freedom, but just like they were trying to ban gathering. Although the government has banned gathering, everybody is going to the street every day. Although the government is trying to control online freedom, is trying to control what we say, what we share, we are still sharing what we want to share because we need the world to know what's happening in Thailand. So they are failing. They are failing at creating the atmosphere of fear because nobody has fears. Everybody is fearless and everybody wants to know what's happening in Thailand.
The bottom line, of course, is that in society, the rule of law should be followed, and we're supporting any democratic solution. Are these two requirements contrary to each other, and can the solution that the students are looking for be achieved?
One of the main reasons why students and many people are not following the Thai rule of law or the emergency decrees is because they are against international human rights standards and they are against Thailand international human rights obligations. The emergency decree of the confirmation that the Thai government, military-backed government, is a dictatorship. It's an authoritarian government. So people are not following the rules of an authoritarian government. People prefer following international human rights law and standards that the Thai government has to comply with. So every time the current Thai government is trying to push for more authoritarian rules, people will always remind them that they have free speech and that if they are supposedly under democracy, then the Thai government should also respect its international human rights obligations. This is why people are not following the emergency decrees, because they are against international human rights standards and international human rights obligations that Thailand has ratified.
Well, thank you for explaining.
And to go back...
Sorry, no, yeah. Carry on.
No, I wanted to say, to go back to your question about the protest leaders being arrested every day. So 8 of them have been released today. But although protest leaders have been arrested, this is a very organic movement. Young people are not looking for leaders. Young people are looking for democracy. So even if you have protest leaders being arrested every day, you have new ones emerging every day. You know, so it's not a question of leaders being arrested. The movement is not going to stop.
So it's organic and will continue to thrive, you say. Thank you very much for informing us about what's happening in Thailand and for joining us today here on A News. Thank you.